The heroes had hoped to find help from the Astral Observatory, to find some way of fighting back the clockwork villains. But the Mechanical Knights had already found the last remaining free wizards in the realm. Fearing they might be too late, the heroes of Trine charged up the hill towards the stargazing tower and their enemies.
Whoever is down there, help me, and be quick about it. I'm barricading door after door up here, but it won't hold them off for long.
Hello, Barbara. It's Barbara, right?
Amadeus, they didn't get you.
No, we're coming up.
So this is what an observatory looks like.
At least Lady Sunny didn't bother blowing this place up.
Some kind of wizarding tricks here.
It's very sophisticated research.
Or a lock.
Fancy bag.
These criminals. I will deal with the fugitive wizard.
Clockwork wizard, the one who spoke, it sounded familiar.
Funny, I was thinking the same thing.
Oh, now I know. That automaton from earlier sounded like Wilhelmina.
The master wizardess of the Astral Academy.
That's right!
Except she doesn't sound so... metal-y.
Watch out for those red beam thingies!
Speed things up down there.
We're coming as fast as we can.
Air travel is boring. The scenery is the same all day, and the quarters are too tight. No idea if we'll be there soon or not. I didn't even wish to go on this field trip. Howl wanted to weld itself into the engines to see if it could take over the ship with its consciousness. Nim and Caribel stopped it just in time. I wonder if gravity makes paper planes fly faster.
Paper planes? Oh, haven't seen those in a while.
Thank you.
This is a nice room.
It's called a planetarium, I believe. It projects stars and planets onto the ceiling, you see.
Oh, that's right. These tin cans!
Barbara, we're coming!
Services include summoning and banishing rituals, skeleton minion training, golem building, carrying heavy objects. Ask for Rex Gloom and Associates.
Sounds like a completely honest little enterprise. In this observatory.
The tower's defenses must have activated when the Clockwork Knights attacked.
Let's carry on. Evil rays or not, we've a wizard to rescue.
That's obviously a ruby and an emerald, and I don't know what the third one is.
They're planets, obviously.
Monsters! Hang on! These clockwork knights are turned to stone!
It must be Valerius is doing.
Good thing one of the wizards can actually defend themselves. Maybe he'll give us a hand. Someone likes gardening.
More planets. Why is one a different colour from the ones we saw before?
Is this an accurate depiction of space, then?
No, they're... Well, you two wouldn't understand important academic concepts.
This is new.
It's magical. It must be the source of the Clockwork Wizard's powers.
Oh, thank the bees you three are here. I need you to go save Helga and Valerius before those monsters steal their magic powers.
What, does it look like we're doing a charity rescue run? We've our own small wizards to save.
Oh, Barbara, we really need your help. My children have been kidnapped. Do you have any idea where they could be?
But of course I'll help you. Right after you go rescue Helga and Valerius.
We don't have time to go rescue every wizard who can't take care of themselves.
Amadeus, think about Helga and Valerius and his stone-turning magic. Do you think your quest will be easier with Clockwork Knights turning both their powers against you?
Oh, that does sound bad. Our powers can't help us much if we're sat next to garden gnomes on Lady Sunny's lawn.
Then it's settled. You go after my friends towards the Bastion of Hope. Let me tell you what I know.